In this video, we will be discussing about ER span and fabric span on the Cisco ECI, how to do the configuration of ER span and fabric span. So for the ER span also, you need to go to the same place where we configure the access span. You go to the fabric, access policy, troubleshooting span, and you need to define the destination group and source group. So likely create span destination group. I have a packet analyzer node connected on the leaf 103, port number 23. And destination type, we have to select EPG. So for the ER span to work, you need to have a IP configured on your packet analyzer tool, whether it's a laptop or any other server. And you need to configure the gateway on the Cisco ACI. So to configure the gateway on Cisco ACI, you need to configure the bridge domain and EPG. So here I have configured the EPG ER span, which is in 10 and TC1. I have access EPTC and the EPG ER span. Okay, so this EPG ER span is connected to the laptop, which is connected to leaf 103.23. Okay, span version by default is a version 2, but you can select based on the requirement. Now here you need to fill the destination IP and the source IP. So destination IP will be the IP which is configured on your laptop or the packet analyzer tool. So in my scenario, I have 100.1.1.2, which is the IP of the laptop, and 100.1.1.1, and it is IP of the BD. So BD ER span, that's I configured, and that's being called in the EPG ER span. Other value you can keep it default. MTU, as we discussed in last video, if you want to capture the packet of, if you want to capture jumbo packet, you can increase the MTU size. By default, I keep it at 9000. We'll submit. Okay. Span source group, I already one span source group defined, so that we discussed in last video. What I'll do, I'll just change the destination label. I'll delete this destination. And I'll select a new destination group, that is leaf 103.23. I'll submit it. So here I have a ESPAN configured. Okay. Now let's go to the configuration of fabric span. So to mirror the packet of the port between leaf and spine, you need to do the fabric span configuration. For that, you need to go to the fabric policies, go to the troubleshooting span destination group. Span destination group is you need to configure the port which where you have a packet analyzer tool is connected. So I have a same leaf 103, port number 23, where I have a laptop connected. Destination type, here you have to do the remote span, ES span, the access span doesn't support. So I'll select EPG, data center one, FTC, and EPG. I have EPG ESPAN. Destination IP of my laptop 100.1.1.2. Source IP I'll configure 100.1.1.1. MTU 9000. So the jumbo packet also can be mirrored. Now in the source group, you create span source group. I'll monitor leaf 101, port number 49, which is connected to the span one. So I'll select the destination group. Source configuring last step. Create source group. Leaf 101, port number 48. Direction. I'm going to mirror the traffic for both incoming and outgoing traffic of this port. Association type is we are there for which domain. So if you want to mirror the traffic of any particular VRF, so say you have a source connected to this VRF A and you want to mirror the traffic of all the source part of that VRF, you can select a VRF or you can select a bridge domain. Say you have some specific source connected to part of that particular bridge domain, you can select a bridge domain. Okay, my name should be 49. I'm going to mirror the 49 port. So I'll select the association as VRF. I have a host connected to VRF1 and I'm going to mirror the port of LIF401 and port number 49. Click on update. Okay, so here you can see the source port is a LIF101, port number 49, direction both, and destination. So my laptop is connected on the LIF103, port number 23. So with this configuration, all packet coming to the port number 49, so enter and exit of the port number 49 will be mirrored for the VRF1. And the packet will be captured on the laptop connected to LIF103 port number 23. I'll submit it. Thank you for watching this video.